तो वह स्वागत है आपका जीडीसी में, दैट इज जीपैट डिस्कशन कॉर्नर में। जैसे कि हम लोग रोज आपके पास वीडियोस लेके आते हैं रिलेटेड टू एमसीक्यू, जो आपको जीपैट क्वालिफाई करने में आसानी दिलाता है, वैसे ही हम लोग ने पहले वाले वीडियो में जो कंसेप्ट क्लियरेंस का जो हम लोग का जो सीरीज चालू है उसमें हम लोग ने कंसेप्ट क्लियर किया था जेनस काइनेज इनहिबिटर्स का। तो वैसे आज हम लोग फिर से आ गए एक कंसेप्ट क्लियर करने के लिए, और वो कंसेप्ट है गाइज ऑटोक्लेव का वैलिडेशन। ऑटोक्लेव हम लोग फार्मेसी में एक अहम हिस्सा है ऑटोक्लेव का, क्योंकि जो भी हम लोग को चीजें स्टरलाइज करनी होती है वो हम लोग ऑटोक्लेव से करते हैं। सबको पता है कि ऑटोक्लेव का टेम्परेचर 121 डिग्री सेल्सियस होना चाहिए, उसको कितना प्रेशर रखना चाहिए वो होता है, पर उसका जो प्रॉपर वैलिडेशन है, उसका जो प्रॉपर एसओपी है, वो किसी को पता नहीं है, और जो हम लोग फॉलो करते हैं नहीं यूजली बेसिस पर। जब भी हम लोग कमर्शियल पे जाएंगे या फिर इंडस्ट्रीज में जाएंगे तभी भी वहां पे वो फिर वैलिडेशन उसका करना पड़ेगा ऑटोक्लेव का। तो उसके लिए आज हम लोग का इस पूरा सेशन में हम लोग जान लेंगे कि वैलिडेशन होता कैसे है ऑटोक्लेव का, और उसमें क्या क्या पॉइंट्स होते हैं जो हम लोग को कंसिडर करने होते हैं। तो जीडीसी टीम फिर से रेडी है एक नए सेशन के साथ। स्टार्ट करते हैं आज के इस सेशन को। आज फिर हमारे पास हमारे प्रोफेसर है डॉक्टर सुश्रुता मुले। प्लीज आइए आप मैम, चालू कीजिए। यस मैम, स्टार्ट।
थैंक यू संकेत। सो टुडे वी विल सी व्हाट इज ऑटोक्लेव वैलिडेशन।
ओके
सो
okay.
फर्स्ट विल सी व्हाट इज वैलिडेशन।
हाँ
सो डेफिनेशन ऑफ वैलिडेशन इज
यस
दिस ऑटोक्लेव कम्स अंडर प्रोसेस वैलिडेशन।
ओके
सो एक्चुअली व्हाट इज प्रोसेस वैलिडेशन? प्रोसेस वैलिडेशन इज अ डॉक्यूमेंटेड प्रोग्राम विच प्रोवाइड्स अ एश्योरेंस दैट स्पेसिफिक प्रोसेस,
ओके
हियर स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन प्रोसेस, इज वर्किंग कंसिस्टेंटली। मीन्स एवरी
ओके
टाइम इट गिव्स द सेम रिजल्ट्स, सेम
ओके
लेवल ऑफ स्टरलाइजेशन, एंड दिस इज डॉक्यूमेंटेड। सो दिस इज द
ओके
प्रोसेस
ओके यस
वैलिडेशन फॉर स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन।
ओके स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन के लिए।
यस, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी व्हाट इज वैलिडेशन ऑफ अ स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन चेम्बर दैट इज ऑटोक्लेव।
ओके ऑटोक्लेव
सो व्हाट इज ऑटोक्लेव? इन ऑटोक्लेव स्टरलाइजिंग एजेंट इज सैचुरेटेड स्टीम अंडर प्रेशर।
ओके स्टीम अंडर प्रेशर। यस
यस
गाइस,
सैचुरेटेड।
आप आपको पूरा वीडियो देखने की जरूरत है, पूरा वीडियो देखिए तभी आपको ये पूरा कंसेप्ट समझ में आएगा। ओके स्टीम अंडर प्रेशर।
एंड प्रिंसिपल ऑफ ऑटोक्लेविंग इज कोएगुलेशन ऑफ माइक्रोबियल प्रोटीन्स।
ओके मतलब जब भी माइक्रोब्स का जो प्रोटीन होता है वो कोएगुलेट हो जाए तभी फिर वो माइक्रोब मर जाएगा। यस ट्रू।
यस, एंड स्पोर्स आर इंक्लूडेड, नॉट ओनली वेजिटेटिव सेल्स ऑफ माइक्रो
ओके
ऑर्गेनिजम्स।
स्पोर्स आर मोर रेजिस्टेंट टू दिस किलिंग मेथड राइट, इसलिए
यस,
स्पोर्स को भी हम लोग देखते हैं। यस हाँ
बिकॉज स्पोर्स इज द सर्वाइवल स्टेज ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स।
हाँ
इन एडवर्स कंडीशंस दे फॉर्म अ स्पोर,
ओके
सो इवन स्पोर्स शुड बी किल्ड बाय स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन, दैट इज एक्सपेक्टेड। एंड यूजुअली स्टीम स्टरलाइजेशन इज डन फॉर लार्ज वॉल्यूम पेरेंटल्स लाइक नॉर्मल सलाइन सोल्यूशन और डेक्सट्रोज सोल्यूशन विच आर थर्मोस्टेबल।
ओके
सो दीज आर द मेन आस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ ऑटोक्लेविंग। एंड वॉट वी लुक फॉर वैलिडेशन इन ऑटोक्लेव?
यस
सो
यस
देर इज ओनली वन एट्रीब्यूट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एट्रीब्यूट वी लुक इन वैलिडेशन ऑफ ऑटोक्लेव, दैट
हाँ
आर माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर किल्ड। दिस इज द ओनली एट्रीब्यूट इन
यस
वैलिडेशन।
आवर मेन मोटिव इज टू किल द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम द
यस
मटेरियल।
यस So different methods used to validate autoclave are, first one is pre-vacuum cycle in sterilization chamber. We know industrial industrial autoclaves are very big in size, like walk-in type, like one room. And whatever air is
present,
yes, you can load the trolleys. Here you can see the some solutions in flask.
Yes.
Conical flask. Some bottles are there. So a big load of material is autoclaved at the same time, at one time.
Okay.
So what we have to do first, you before starting steam sterilization, whatever air is present inside the chamber,
we have to remove that. Yeah.
Yes, we have to evacuate.
Evacuate. Yeah.
So for this, we can apply vacuum pulses. That is negative pressure.
Negative pressure.
So whatever air is present is sucked outside.
Okay.
So is the air removed totally? It is totally evacuated. Is autoclave totally evacuated? That first
we have to find out whether the air is present inside or not.
First step in validation, that is pre-vacuum cycles. How many pre-vacuum cycles are required?
Yes.
See, this validation we perform for one particular instrument or equipment.
Okay.
So in that one particular autoclave chamber, how many pre-vacuum cycles are required to remove the air?
Okay. So they will be varying on the basis of the equipment. As the equipment will change, the pre-vacuum cycle also will change.
Yeah. So this we are talking about a particular equipment. Validation we do for a particular equipment.
For a particular, right.
So this pre-vacuum cycles we have to note. You have to perform repeatedly pre-vacuum cycles to remove the entire air from the chamber.
Okay. So ma'am, how can we analyze that particularly the vacuum has been created and all air has been evacuated successfully from the chamber? Do we have some analysis method?
Yeah, we have. It is called as a Bovidic test.
Okay.
So Bovidic test is a pack of papers.
Okay.
Which will change the color.
Yeah. We can see this. It's yellow.
Yes, initially yellow color is there. They're stained in such a way. They're stained in such a way that if there is air, it blackens. Yellow color becomes totally black. If there is no air, then it is a successful vacuum, evacuated autoclave, successfully.
Okay. Means initially it is yellow in color. And as soon as the whole vacuum is being generated inside the chamber, it turns into black.
Yes.
Okay.
So in case if it is a mixed color.
If you are having a mixture of yellow and black, it means it fails.
Yeah, fails to again apply vacuum and again evacuate.
Okay. Second cycle we are there.
Yeah. So this is the first step of validation. Second step, heat distribution studies.
Okay.
So heat is in the form of steam. So this steam distribution, steam should equally distribute inside the chamber. Since the chamber is very big.
Yes.
We are talking about large scale autoclave.
Yeah, we can, ma'am, we can completely relate this situation with mixing API into large excipient powder for making a tablet or capsules. If the API concentration is too small in comparison with excipients, we check for the distribution, right?
See, this is autoclaving, basically.
No, it's like a similar thing that we have to check that whether the thing is been equally distributed or not.
Yes.
So in autoclave, it's a heat.
Yeah. So is the steam distributing throughout the chamber, each and every corner?
Okay. Huh.
So steam under pressure.
Yes.
So it is either 15 psi, 15 pounds per square inch, or in kg it is 1.1 to 1.2 kg per centimeter.
1.2 kg per centimeter square.
So since it is temperature, time, and pressure process, temperature is 121 degrees. Pressure is 15 psi.
15
or 1.1 to 1.2 kg per centimeter square, and duration is 12 minutes. This is a standard conditions.
Okay. 121 degrees Celsius, 15 psig pressure, and for 12 minutes.
Yes.
Yes.
So, first, when the chamber is empty, pass the steam.
Yes.
And these are the thermocouples.
Okay, yeah. Thermocouple is the material which we can use to analyze na, whether the validation is proper or not.
Yeah,
okay.
Temperature, we have to see that each and every corner. Point
at every corner, yeah.
Same 121 degrees temperature is maintained.
Okay.
So these are the 16 thermocouples. We have to suspend these thermocouples in the autoclave.
Okay, we have to suspend it. We don't have to stuck it on the wall of the container,
no,
right?
We are not supposed to touch, otherwise temperature will change.
Okay, we are going to suspend it, yeah.
Yeah. So these are the 16 we can see in the black oval shape. So these are the thermocouples.
Ma'am, here's the question that how can we connect these thermocouples with that particular chamber?
Means, do we with have the help some of heat resistant threads.
Okay, yes. Heat resistant tapes.
Threads.
Okay.
So these are the thermocouples attached to inner chamber of autoclave.
Okay.
Thermocouples should be very accurate in reading the temperature. So its accuracy is plus or minus 0.5%.
deviation.
So you can see here 16 thermocouples readout. Digital readout. So you can what you can see here, the temperature of the steam is 121 to 124 degrees. Minimum 121.
Yes.
And if any thermocouple is showing 123, it's allowed. Up to 124, it's allowed.
Okay. Okay.
So all the temperature readouts. All the temperature readouts are given in the graph. So you can see thermocouple number 2. Sensor 2.
Okay.
And sensor 2 is not showing any temperature, so sensor 2 is failing. Steam is not reaching at that spot.
Means out of 16, sensor number 2 is not showing anything, so it fails.
Yeah. Steam is not reaching to that part where the thermocouple number 2 is there, sensor.
Okay.
So this is very important part of steam sterilization, that temperature should reach each and every part.
Okay. Yes.
So this we have to perform at empty autoclave also, and after loading of autoclave.
Okay. Yeah.
So this is the mechanism of autoclave. We pass steam inside autoclave. There is pressure gauge. There is safety wall. See the door of autoclave. It is
closed tightly.
Airtight. It is. So steam should not come out, should not leak from autoclave. So this is the basic mechanism of autoclave.
This is a normal working of an autoclave, right?
Yes.
We have a steam jacket, we have a door, we have a temperature, we have a way for extra steam, or we can say waste. There is safety valve, pressure valve. Yeah.
Correct. I think everyone knows what is the working of autoclave. All the students.
Yes. It's simple like barthan, jisme hum log, it's like similar to a cooker, pressure cooker.
Yeah. There is manual, pressure cooker is manual.
Yes.
So this pressure indicator is very important.
Okay.
How much pressure, steam has
been. Only at 15 PSI here.
Yeah.
So we have to check whether the pressure rises above that level or not.
Yeah. Then only your sterilization time starts.
Okay, after reaching that pressure only.
Correct. So that was about heat distribution study. Now we have to see what is F0 value. If there is any one cold spot in your autoclave, naturally your exposure time will get increased.
Okay.
Because the temperature is less at that particular place, corner. So what is F0 value? F0 value is nothing but sterilization equivalent time.
Okay.
So if your time is 12 minutes and if you have identified a cold spot in autoclave, naturally it won't be 12 times, it will be more than 12 minutes.
Okay.
You have to,
if you are finding a hot spot, then you have to increase the sterilization time.
Yes.
Okay.
So Z value. Two concepts we have to understand first before F0 value. Z value and D value. Yes. So D value is
we learn this D value and Z value in microbiology, right?
Yeah, it is autoclave actually, basically. D for destruction, you can say.
Okay.
So D value is a time required to reduce microbial population, reduce or kill, by one decimal point or one logarithmic reduction.
One logarithmic reduction means agar 1000 microbes hai, to 900 should get killed or only 100 should left over, more left.
Correct.
Pe 100 bachne chahiye
khali. Correct. So that is called a 90% reduction.
Okay, 90% reduction. Yes.
And Z value is the temperature at which this reduction, one logarithmic reduction occurs.
Okay, so D value is the time and Z value is the temperature.
Yeah, temperature.
दोनों का condition same ही होगा, logarithmic reduction.
Correct.
Okay.
So Z value for autoclave, Z value is fixed for particular sterilization instrument equipment.
Okay.
In autoclave, Z value is 10 degrees. Means with 10 degrees, you can achieve one logarithmic reduction.
Okay.
So if you want to reduce logarithmic reduction to two logarithms, two decimal points, then your Z value is 20.
Okay. To viewers के लिए clear करेंगे हम लोग कि two decimal reduction मतलब क्या होता है. Two decimal reduction मतलब अगर 1000 microbes है तो एक decimal reduction मतलब 100 बचने चाहिए, 900 degrade होने चाहिए, reduction होना चाहिए. Two decimal मतलब 1000 की direct 10 बचने चाहिए ना.
Yes.
Okay. Remaining 990 should get reduced.
So validation, important point in validation is F0 value calculations.
Okay, yes.
After identifying cold spot.
Huh.
Equivalent sterilization time. So So how to identify cold spots? It is given
yeah,
in
the this is the main question. We are talking about cold spots, how to prevent it, what are its importance, but how to identify it? Yes. So we have an identification tube.
Yes. So this is a slanted tube inserted inside the chamber. And you can see
okay, what is the importance of this tilted tube? Means why it is being in a slant position or slant orientation?
It covers the whole part of autoclave, whole chamber.
Okay, okay.
So here we are identifying a red color spot is cold spot. In the left figure, G.
Huh.
G is cold spot.
Okay.
So this is what the cold spot representation.
Huh.
Now the next test is biochallenge test with the help of biological indicators.
Okay, BI means biological indicators used. Huh.
So how you ensure that your sterilization is complete?
Yes, yes.
So these are the biological indicators are nothing but spores of bacteria.
Okay.
So these are the spores of Geobacillus stereothermophilus organism.
Okay, these are specific bacteria, right? Geophilus, Geothermophilus, okay.
So they are most heat resistant.
Huh.
Spores of this bacteria are most heat resistant. That's why we have selected the Geobacillus stereothermophilus.
Geothermophilus, okay.
So these are the spore strips available in market.
Okay, we are using that particular strips directly or we are going to convert it into ampoule?
Yeah, we have to suspend it in the saline solution, some fluid.
Okay.
You can see in the left figure and you have to seal the ampoule.
Then the ampoules are ready to just place in the chamber.
Yeah, these are the spore suspension okay. With a dye. Colored is a dye. I will show you
color
the next slide.
Okay.
So this is
some complete procedure है जहाँ पे हम लोग जो strips से spores उठा के ampoule बना के उसका कैसा हम लोग analysis करते हैं उसका layout है यहाँ पे. Okay ma'am.
So these spores are inside the ampoule which we can see in the red color.
हाँ.
And this ampoule is inserted inside a flexible plastic vial.
Okay, ampoule is glass का बना हुआ and then external we have a plastic tube
and plastic cap of this plastic vial is perforated green
okay.
Color cap
okay so that cap can allow the steam to penetrate inside it na?
Yeah, see in the center figure when we start autoclave So this vial is squeezed, plastic vial, outside vial, and ampoule breaks.
Due to heat.
Correct. Ampoule breaks.
Okay.
And the spores, these are released into medium.
Okay.
Then, if the sterilization is faulty. Sterilization is not achieved.
It will change the color.
Color will change. It will be yellow color.
Okay. Initially it's red in color. Then if the validation is not proper, then it will change its color to red to yellow color.
Correct.
Okay.
If it remains red, your sterilization is complete.
Okay, complete.
If it changes color. Spores are viable. Viable means they are surviving.
They are survived and they are showing growth.
So this test is also very important. Biological indicator test.
Biological indicators because we are using the microorganisms inside this as an indicator.
So that's all. These are the main important steps. In autoclave validation And as we saw in the definition, it is a documentary evidence.
Okay. So we have to, why it is called CGMP? Why it is called CGMP, ma'am?
CGMP is current good manufacturing practices.
We have to submit those documents for some authorities.
Yeah.
So that the instruments are being validated.
Keep a record of authorities. And on inspection, you have to show this record, validation record.
So this is a possible GPAT question from this particular topic. Okay. So this is the question, right?
Yeah, this question.
The biological indicator used in sterilization by steam is, options are, okay, Bacillus subtilis, Geobacillus cheirothermophilus, Pseudomonas diminuta, and Bacillus pumilis. Okay. Ma'am, for sterilization of means, if you are validating sterilization by steam, then we are using only Geobacillus thermophilus, na?
Correct.
Okay.
And why we are using?
So, okay, there is a question that why only we are using Geobacillus cheirothermophilus, because they are resistant to temperature.
Yes.
At 121 degrees Celsius. Okay, yes.
So
इससे पता चलेगा कि अगर Geobacillus cheirothermophilus अगर survive नहीं कर पा रहा है तो फिर validation जो है वो बराबर है.
So that's all in the autoclave validation.
Okay. तो गाइस हम लोगों ने यहाँ पे समझ लिया है कि ऑटोक्लेव का जो समझते हैं हम लोग कि ऑटोक्लेव तो क्या खाली डाल दिया टेम्परेचर चालू कर दिया हो जाएगा, वैसे नहीं है. ऑटोक्लेव का एक प्रॉपर एसओपी होता है जो हम लोग को फॉलो करना होता है. ऑटोक्लेव का वैलिडेशन भी इम्पोर्टेंट है, जिसके वजह से हम लोग को मालूम पड़ेगा कि जो फंक्शन ऑटोक्लेव करना चाहिए वो प्रॉपर वो रेगुलर बेसिस पे कर रहा है या फिर नहीं, या फिर अगर नहीं कर रहे तो उसमें क्या प्रिवेंटिव मेजर्स हम लोग को लेने चाहिए. तो थैंक यू मैम, जीडीसी टीम की वजह से आप यहाँ पे आए और हम लोग को ऑटोक्लेव वैलिडेशन एकदम लूसिड लैंग्वेज हम लोग को एक सब एक्सप्लेन करके बताया. तो गाइज हमारे चैनल को फटाफट सब्सक्राइब कर लीजिए और वीडियो को लाइक कर दीजिए और आपके दोस्तों के साथ शेयर भी कीजिए, और हम लोग ऐसे आते रहेंगे नए नए वीडियोज लेके आपके लिए. तब तक हम लोग यही कहेंगे कि वी बिलोंग टू जीपैट डिस्कशन कॉर्नर, जीपैट क्वालिफाई करना ही है. थैंक यू मैम.
थैंक यू वेरी मच.